An explosion Friday at a South Salinas industrial park has led now to a state of emergency being declared. City and county officials made that declaration today, hoping to recoup the cost of putting out the blaze. It destroyed a building on Dayton Street. Today, firefighters say that fire is suspicious. Action News reporter Felix Cortez has the story live from our Salinas newsroom.
Well, Dan, firefighters say they're focusing on one person and one person only, a man who put together an explosive mix of chemicals.
Firefighters say it's miraculous this man survived the explosion with only minor burns and scrapes. But the investigation surrounding him might cut much deeper. Investigators say he made a chemical mixture that rocked the South Salinas business park and set up a black plume of smoke that could be seen for miles.
He was not permitted by the city of Salinas to do what he was in fact doing. So that brings into question really what his business was.
Investigators aren't identifying the man, but they want to know what he was mixing and why. At a news conference, the fire chief was quick to squash rumors he was operating a meth lab.
The chemical list that we've been provided and we found at the scene does not have the chemicals in it that would make meth.
But according to the chief, some of the man's story isn't adding up.
We're actually looking into the company that he has called because there's some discrepancies on actually what that business is. Everything's suspicious until we can prove otherwise.
In the wake of that explosion, a green goo has contaminated this drainage ditch. The chemical makeup still unknown, and health officials trying to keep it out of the city's groundwater and the Monterey Bay.
And the last thing we want to do is have this stuff go down gradient into Carr Lake, number one, and then it eventually can go out to the marine sanctuary. And that is what we're trying to prevent at all costs.
Well, workers have contaminated water has been tightly contained. Health officials were hoping to have some test results back today to really get an idea of what type of chemicals they're dealing with in that ditch. Spokeswoman for the county says they'll begin the cleanup process as early as tomorrow. Dan.
All right. Thank you, Felix. Meanwhile, investigators say they plan to re-interview the man who was there at the time of the explosion. That'll happen later this week.